if I want my daughter to do her homework, you know, that's my first reach. You better do your homework. You know, machines are going to be smarter than you in 5 years. And, oh, okay. And then she'll go do her homework. I'm like, you got to, exactly. You got to be smart. But there are roles I think that won't ever go away. You're never going to have, like, if you think of the roles that won't go away, I think those are the paths that people need to think of. Okay. These are secure areas. Management. You're never going to be like, you're never going to go into your AI bosses, you know, come in here and step into my office. There's never going to be one of those AI guys. Like you see it now, like marketing bots, you know, I have them and stuff like that, but they lose their personal touch. Like, I think what AI should do in terms of marketing is it should get the doors open to bring in that personal marketing. So like in terms of things with, you mentioned Active Campaign. So I'm a huge advocate of Active Campaign. I'm usually on every office hours. It's Tuesday at 11 and Friday at 2. And I'm on every single one most of the time. And so I'm always asking different things of how I can use marketing automation to make my business better. But I'm using it in a different way. I'm using it more as a like a 30,000 foot view so I can see engagement rates. I use the AI to see how many times has this person been to my website? How many times has this person opened my email? If they've opened my email this number of times, score them this. And I'll use lead scoring. And then after that, what do I do? Now, put these people into this type of list if they've bought, or put these people into this type of list if they've added us on social media. And marketing automation and AI, and that's not really AI, that's more marketing automation in a sense. But the goal is for me to then understand who are my advocates out of the thousands of people that are on our list.